Breaking weather news right now, the very latest advisory on Hurricane Sandy.
Clearly, climate change is here.
75 mile per hour Category 1 hurricane moving north-northeast.
We live on the water, in the water. In fact, it's the water and the great commerce that the water made possible that led to the growth of New York City.
Latest information shows that the storm is moving faster than before.
And we're also vulnerable because of the water.
Conditions outside are dangerous, and they're only going to get worse in the hours ahead.
Seeing the boardwalk float down the street and the damage the boardwalk did to specifically the front of my house.
The water rushed underneath the boardwalk, chunks of it now flying down the streets.
We're no longer in South Beach. It just wasn't safe anymore.
I have some video of some kind, an explosion at a Con Ed plant on 14th Street.
One of the great things about New York is that we rally together around emergencies.
And every time that something really serious has happened, New Yorkers have stepped up. They've taken each other's backs. They've fed each other. They've clothed each other. They've supported each other.
Superstorm Sandy really demonstrated how important it is to prepare for extreme weather events, as they're going to be increasingly more frequent and more severe due to climate change.
Well, I would say that New York City is the point of the spear in addressing climate change.
Starting back in 2008, New York City began to develop key programs to develop a resilient city.
I think the city was definitely more prepared for Superstorm Sandy than we would have been had we not done the work we did inside PlanYC. And just look at Brooklyn Bridge Park, which was built in a way that was, you know, thinking about storm surge and sea level rise.
There were many vulnerable communities that we now know are going to need more help. And so all of us are working to think about how we strengthen that resiliency.
I've spoken to thousands of residents since the storm. I've only spoken to one person who said they want to leave. What we're thinking about is how do we protect the community to make it so that this community can thrive and people can stay.
Let me be clear. We are not going to abandon the waterfront. We're not going to leave the Rockaways or Coney Island or Staten Island South Shore. But we can't just rebuild what was there and hope for the best. We have to build smarter and stronger and more sustainably. I have every confidence that by confronting this challenge head on, we will succeed.